Hello. In this video I'm going to show how to connect via Java WebSockets to the eerie.health solution. So first I will create a Java project from scratch. I will use the archetype given by Spence UK. So what I do is I put in here the command to create a Java project. This is this one. I will make this a little bit bigger so then it's easier to read, and you can directly copy it from the GitHub page. So then let's press enter. Now I have to put in interactive mode the group ID, so it's health.eerie. Then the artifact ID, it will be WebSocket Java Connect, and then I will just take the version and we'll just use this package. So this now generated the package. Let's go in there and then let's try to build this, Maven install. So some dependencies are downloaded. It comes with Mockito and SRJ, I think so, and also has a predefined unit test. This is what we're also going to use. So this all worked. So the next thing what I will do is I will open Visual Studio Code in this project. Just a quick view in the pom.xml. So what we will need now is we will need, besides the testing dependencies to Jupyter, so actually we won't need these ones, so I will remove them. And also for build management, this is nice here for version pinning, but technically we won't need them. So let's just get rid of them. And here this works. And now we will need a Java WebSocket implementation, so we will use Tyrus, and we will take this Java WebSocket implementation from the eerie.health project. So if we go here into the pom.xml, we will find a dependency to Tyrus, and Tyrus is the WebSocket implementation that was part of the Java E specification. So let's go here, let's put this in here. So let's save, then also tell Visual Studio Code that he should update. And then in the test case, we will just reuse this application test. It used SRJ, but we also will get rid of this. So this is called WebSocket test. And now let's just save it. Then just as an example, I will implement a failing test case. Hello fail. So also my Visual Studio Code is configured in the way in the moment I press save, it will automatically add not find imports. This can be done in the settings. So now it fails. Awesome. This is how we should start the test case. And now we have to implement a WebSocket. For doing this, I will copy a predefined implementation in the eerie.ps application. So there is a program called WebSocket Client Endpoint, this one here. And I will just copy it and create a file here. New file, WebSocket Client Endpoint.java. So let's paste all this here. Save. And now we can use this class in the application test to connect to our system. So how do we do that? We just create a WebSocket client endpoint. WebSocket client endpoint equals new WebSocket client endpoint. Then we put in the URL localhost clone 8080 WebSocket, and then it has to be a URL, so new URL. I think it has to be a URI. I think like this. And let's throw all the applications. And now let's run this test case and let's see what's happening. It says opening WebSocket. Let's also check our running server. WebSocket opened, WebSocket closed, worked. This was just our Java WebSocket connection. And now let's also do something with that. So to do something here, we have to send a message. And in this particular case, we will send just a request settings message. So if we go to eui-ps app WebSocket messages, so this is the URL where you will find all our messages. And we will just use this request settings message. So this request settings message just requests the settings from the system. And this is how we do that. And now let's run this again. And here you don't see anything, but you will see here that the request settings message was now sent. Here's the request settings message. And now we have to process the response. So for processing responses here, we have to register a handler. So new handler, and now we can just create a new message handler. So new WebSocket.messageHandler, and then add all unreturned messages. So this is now how we handle a message. And in this particular case, we just want to output it. Message. And now we run this again. And now you receive this message. So this is how this worked. We sent the request message to the eui.health system and got the settings payload message as a response. And what we can also do is we can debug here. So if I right click now here and click on test debug, I'm able to debug here. And what you see is that the system just stopped. And the reason for this is that the WebSocket is not waiting until it gets a response. It will directly quit the process here. So as a workaround, you can just do a thread sleep. So for example, 20 seconds. And then the system will hold here a lot longer. So let's also throw the interrupt exception here. A throw declaration. And now so now it's waiting 20 seconds and I have to start it in debug. So let's stop, let's do this again. And now here it will be 20 seconds, and here you can hover over the over this message, or you can also put in a watch expression. And if you look into the watch expression, you will see here that the string is here, that the settings are here. And if you just continue, it will output the code on the console. Then thanks a lot, and see you in the next session.